I got a new toy in the mail from China. This little DCC decoder. It came from China, or I ordered it from China, but it's actually from a Portuguese company called Lays DCC or something like that. Is this thing going to focus on there? I don't know. Anyway, I'll put up a snapshot of the page that I bought it from on AliExpress. They seem to be a legitimate company, although the only place I've ever seen their stuff is on AliExpress. And it was cheap too, which is why I bought it. $12 American, or 15 or 16 Canadian, something like that. So the listing calls it DCC decoder 6 wire for model train with stay alive. Stay alive is what these two wires are here. I've never had that on a decoder before, mostly because I haven't bought a decoder in the last 15 plus years. According to the documentation, you connect a small capacitor to these guys and it keeps the decoder powered as it goes over rough bits of track or dirt or whatever, which seems like a slick idea. I want to try that out. Also, it's the only model decoder they make, and it has a lot more wires than I'm used to. Where's one of these old decoders that I pulled off here from in another video? This one just has rails, motor, and headlights. This one also has, we got here, 2 for rails, 2 for motor, lighting common. I'm not counting the colors right, I'm just counting lighting common. And then 4 functions, so 2 lights and then 2 other things, which is pretty cool. I don't know what I'm going to use it for. It's also tiny. Where'd this thing go again? There's what the decoders that I'm used to are sized like. This is a cruddy old MRC one. It probably still works, but it only has 6, supports the low speed step mode, 16 speed steps, and you have to put the layout into a different mode, and it's just not worth the headache for me. So I've swapped most of my locomotives out to either the cheapest Digitrax I could find, which at the time was DH-121, or TCS T1s, which again are another old one that's not available anymore. So this guy, tiny, which is awesome. What do we got here? 1 centimeter wide by 2.5 approximately long, not counting the wires because they're adjustable. Which, in scale, what's that work out to? Well, who cares about in scale? It's whether it'll fit or not. So, the listing says that it's 2 amp peak, 1 amp continuous, which is pretty standard. 100 milliamps per function. Recommend less than 600 milliamps for the motor. It says it's HO scale or N. I just happen, even though I model HO scale, for some reason that I don't understand, I happen to have an N scale locomotive. I don't understand it. So, let's crack into this thing and just, well, actually, no, we don't even have to. It's narrower than the hood. Much narrower than this brake cooling radiator here. It looks like there might be room in the cab, but I wouldn't want to put it in there because who wants to see decoder through the windows? So I'm betting that with shaving a bit of weight out of here, you could easily get this into here. But that's not what I'm going to do. Park you out of the way. I'm going to put it in this one. This is an HO scale Athern Jeep, fairly standard. Again, this is probably a 20-year-old model. the old Atherin Blue Box standard basic. There's a million of them out there. They're a bit of a pain to put DCC into, mostly because the one motor brush picks up directly off the chassis, and so the chassis is hot to one rail, and then the other rail goes through the pickups to a wire to the top brush. I'll show you that better when I crack it open. But you have to do a little bit of fiddling around in there to make it work. But that's not an issue. Anyone who's actually looking closely and has experience with 20-year-old models might recognize that this one has some add-ons on it. The bell's not how it would have come. The mufflers, the horn, this panel's been replaced, a few other things. This I bought used off a guy at the club way back when. And it's a really good runner, considering that it's just the standard chassis. I think he's done a little bit of work on the gearing. Anyways, I'm going to shift around here and crack this thing open. I'm going to do probably two different videos out of this. One will be a video actually installing the decoder. This one is going to be just looking at the decoder itself and reviewing it. This thing's only got the front and back headlight in it, so I don't know what I'm going to use the other two functions for, if I'm going to use them at all. But really, for as cheap as this thing is, if it works, then I'm not really that stressed about having extra functions that I'm not using. One thing I am noticing, though, I'm not sure if I'm thrilled about, these wires are really, really tiny. Where is... that'll do. Compared to the wires from this other cheap decoder, get up there. You can see that the red wire here is a fair bit skinnier. Although the voltages and currents involved, and it's going to be really short to leads by the time we get it dealt with. The longest ones are going to be going to the headlights, but I'll try and use as much of the wiring that's in there as possible. Okay, it occurs to me that before I actually go to the effort of putting this in a locomotive to test run it, I should actually just test it out and see if it works. So, here is my elaborate testing setup. I've got the track wires, black and red, connected to the track. This is actually my programming track, so I'm not going to mess with all the other locomotives. I've got the gray and orange connected to this motor that I pulled out of a box that I'd forgotten I had. And got my throttle set for 3, which is supposed to be, according to the NMRA standard, the default address for a factory new decoder. So, let's see what happens. Motor's turning. That's nice. So which way is it going? It's going that way. Going that way. Nice. Okay. So the... right now it's going reverse, so I'll set that back to forward. The forward light should be white wire and blue is the lighting common. So here's the light that I pulled out of my locomotive, my victim locomotive over there. So I'll just, since I've run out of clip leads, just twisty twist that on there. Blue and white. Nee, 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 nee. And that's not holding. Right. Pause. Okay. Soldered the light on there. Now then. Okay, that's one direction. Other direction. Function zero. Hey, a front a light. In reverse. Nice. All right. That's exactly what I expected it to do. Now then, let's think about these two wires over here, which are the keep alive, which I've never actually played with before. So right now, get some dirty track. That happens. Now then, I'll go and pause again and solder in. Peter's research says 100 microfarad capacitor. So, just happen to have one. It's a little big for the mechanicals. Actually, let's try something a bit lighter duty first. What's this one? Try 33. Okay, back in a second. Okay, more suspicious soldering. I found another light bulb in my box of toys. So now I've got a forward and reverse light. Yay. And I've added the capacitor, which, like I said before, is a 33 microfarad. So, well, that's not spectacular. Okay, let's try with 100 microfarad like the internet suggests. Who am I to argue with the internet? Okay, now let's try it. Lights on. Okay, I'm not seeing the awesomeness of that right now. What's going on over here? Hello capacitor. So that's got 10 volts across it. Oh, I'm not sure if I'm going to leave that in or not. I don't know. Any of you guys had experience using this keep alive idea? Maybe I need a more massive capacitor. However, I really don't want to, because that's going to take up a lot of space that I don't really have. Think. Anyway, the decoder itself works happily. I'm good with that. So, into the locomotive it goes for more testing. All right, now after a certain amount of swearing and fiddling about to get it, the shell on it, here it is. Those light tubes work really well. Put a lot of light out the headlight, and no spill, no glowing on the side of the shell. That's excellent. I'm quite pleased with that. So something else that I discovered. Notice on the hill here, it's not slowing down. That decoder has back EMF in it. And a fairly decent implementation of it too. I am pleased. Didn't stall out on the turnout over there like a lot of locomotives do. Yay. Yeah, then what's top speed look like? Okay, top speed's ridiculous. I'm pleased. Where'd he go? Yep, I think that decoder is definitely a keeper. The locomotive needs some mechanical help, but the decoder is definitely a keeper, especially for, what was it, $15 Canadian, $12 American? How can you go wrong?